taking on Chris G, Red Bull Proving Grounds champ, Chris G from Team Wong Nation.
And just really putting Guile on the map for five.
Yes, absolutely. There were a lot of players that were looking to play Guile when he first came out. They did not feel like he was a strong character. Chris G really has brought this character to the forefront and opened up a lot of people's eyes in terms of what his potential is. Nice, we're going to get a V-skill check on the fireball back. Chris G. Gets a telegraph jump in, but he got away with it though. Nice, wake up jab is going to confirm with the boom. Amplifies, looking to put him back into the corner. Nice. Nice angle on the DX Devil's reverse. Ooh, missed opportunity for the crush counter combo.
Slowly getting in.
Yep. But as I was saying earlier, like Chris is looking to keep him out as much as possible and establish the neutral game. Tampa Bison is looking to exert as much pressure as possible. Nice crossover on the short. Baits out the V-trigger reversal. Sorry, the V-reversal. There it is. Crouch Fierce cuts off the Devil's reverse. Chris G reestablishes himself.
Chris G has V-trigger, and that is really where the Chris G magic happens. I mean, it's just, it gets ridiculous, and yep. Here we go.
Now he's going to have tons of opportunities. He's got also got full critical art as well. So there it is. He's just going to be able to use one stock of his critical art to get two EX booms out of his V-trigger. All up on his face. Open for the boom. Nice crouch Fierce again.
Just sees him try to jump in and is ready and waiting.
Yep. And you have to be aware of this, that Bison's double reverse has a very wide hurt box. A lot of players end up blocking when that happens right there. The hurt box is very, very wide. A lot of players stand there, they watch it happen, and the double's reverse is plus on block. So you run into a situation where you get pressured by Bison when it never had to be that way. Tampa Bison looking to put pressure on once again in the corner. Ooh, that axe!
Tampa Bison keeping him there. Oh, jumps over, yeah.
Get a good read on the Sonic Boom there. Bison in a very comfortable position.
Okay, Chris G not locked in the corner, slowly getting out. Here we go, V-trigger.
Gets the crossover. Now he's going to put Bison into the corner. Wow, he goes up and down, coming down four.
Chris G slowly evening out the life there.
We're about even in life here. Chris G has used that V-trigger that you were talking about earlier, Jack, to his advantage. Brought this all the way back.
Slowly working him over to the other corner.
Now Chris G is probably going to be looking for air. There it is. He was looking for a crossover on the Devil's Reverse. A lot of Bison players are prone to cross over the plane when in V-trigger.
Chris G took that and he had no life left. Like, he was down to nothing.
Clutch.
Nothing.
He is as clutch as it gets. A former world champion in Marvel vs. Capcom, or the actually reigning, defending, and undisputed world champion of Marvel vs. Capcom. He knows what it's like to be under pressure, hold steady, and come through with a victory.
Alucard coming up next to fight against Chris G.
Now, are we going to see a birdie in this spot?
I'm thinking he will likely pick birdie, although he has so many characters. I mean, Alucard just has such diversity, which, I mean, you don't really see too many people have more than their main and a pocket.
And a pocket, yeah. He is definitely a jack of all trades. I met Alucard about 4 years ago playing Hugo. Ultra had just dropped and he was using Hugo. I met him at a combo break, or UFGTX, my mistake. And everybody was like, oh, Hugo's a terrible character, nobody can make him use him. And meanwhile, Alucard's like, let me show you how to respect this character. You know, and then now, same thing. He's using a character, initially very strong, Birdie, and then a lot of players have dropped him, thinking that he's not up to snuff. But, you know, you look at XYZZY, and you look at the strength of Alucard's Birdie, you see this character is a force to be reckoned with. So, all right, here we go. Team TBA.
Fight.
Taking on Wong Nation. Chris G has defeated Tampa Bison. Looking to do the same to Alucard here.
Chris G applying that fireball pressure. Following up behind. Really working Alucard into the corner. Alucard retaliating, trying to bring it back to neutral. Very nice missing that. Alucard using the armor and then going through getting in.
Chris G SG, look to get in there with jump four. Very long hitbox on that jumping attack. Ooh, cuts off the jump in. Ooh, Chris G was looking to punish for the use of banana, but Alucard says, no son, sit in the corner. Ooh, that overhead does whiff. Once again, Alucard said, you can't jump on me.
Chris G escaping stun, but maybe not escaping death in this situation. Alucard just has such a life lead.
Oh, this is interesting. Look at those Sonic moves going around him like a belt.
Oh, the timing on that was a good one.
Now, Alucard's got a ton of resources here.
Ooh, that EX Dolphin Dive misses. Really good blocking there. Oh, I love that. Used the armor, broke through, and got Chris G in the corner.
Now, just so people are wondering, the Bullhorn, when in V-Trigger, you're going to get three hits of armor there. Or sorry, two hits of armor. So the third hit, that is why it punched through. Wow, Guile's hair is even higher than it was before with that headdress.
Now let's see if Chris G can keep the banana helmet on for the whole round, which I think would be extremely hype.
I would love to see a perfect with banana helmet. He's making it work right now. He gets an optimal combo there. Ooh.
The Dolphin Dive. Take that hat off.
Take that hat off.
Sit down.
Chris G in a very prime position here. Clips him on the jump in, follows in the V skill. Ooh, look for that frame trap overhead. With the, sorry, not overhead. Frame trap stand strong.
Again, Alucard definitely has to switch up and adapt to sort of make the comeback here. Very low life.
Wow. He came in there with jump forward and got away with it. Chris G seems to have abandoned his anti-air game. He's let Alucard get away with two jump ins that he never would have otherwise with crouched fears.
And stayed very patient there, just kind of waiting for Alucard to do something and then use the Sonic Boom and just said, no, thank you.
So we are going to a third game. Both guys just about even with when it concerns resources. Wow, see that? This is what I was talking about earlier. Crouched fears for Guile, very strong, very large, very long hitbox. Ooh, he was preemptively. That was a hard read by Alucard. He was looking for Chris G to jump forward and beat him to the punch, but instead gets punished for his trouble. Both guys even in health. Alucard trying to find his way in. Oh, what do we got? Oh, we got cans. Yeah, we got cans. This is trouble, Jackie.
EX Dolphin Dive again.
Oh wow, he got clipped. This is trouble. This is big trouble.
It's just going to keep going and going and going. We're at 18 hits. Here we go.
Now what does he have for a follow-up? He's going to do a reset?
Oh my goodness. Enough with that nice EX there.
Ooh, he went in with empty short. Does not pan out. Oh wow, I'm pretty sure that was supposed to be a V-trigger cancel there. He did not do it. I love it. I absolutely love that. Tossing the can is a really big risk in that spot. The move takes forever to come out. And Chris G sees the opportunity, recognizes the can, uses EX Sonic Boom, flies across the screen really quickly, and punishes the use of the can for the victory. Now you can see him right there. He's whipping his hands around. He's like, yo, I got the fastest fireball, son.
Phenom coming up, has to hold it down for his team. Chris G has not left that spot. That chair is warm.
Mm-hmm.
That chair is warm.
It's all Chris G right now. He's up 2-0 for his team, the Wong Nation in full effect, feeling good.
Round one, fight.
Phenom about to take a seat. I see that King of Fighters 14 World Championships coming up soon. So much talent in there. King of Fighters, fantastic. Fantastic series.
KOF. I have definitely purchased a lot of KOF recently. Lots of my friends in Brazil could not get KOF, so I definitely have had to send many copies. Yeah.
Is it just sell out or is it unavailable?
No, they are poor. they cannot afford it. So
yo, shout out to the poor.
Sponsor. They're sponsored.
Yo.
But that's the FGC life, right? You help where you can.
That's
you
exactly
help
it.
Where you can.
Help your community out. Now, Phenom is a monster, Nikali. All right? He is primed to rush Chris G down. Chris G is going to be at his wit's end trying to keep this beast of a character out.
And from what we saw recently, picking Nikali is a perfectly good choice because we saw Red Bull Proving Grounds, the top 16, people just steamrolled with Nicali.
Yep. The Nightmare out of Seattle, Washington, had a very strong showing. Came fourth at the Red Bull Supergrounds Finals. Congratulations to him. Very strong showing among a very stacked field. But here we go. This is Phenom taking on Chris G. Chris G is looking to OCV and move forward in this tournament. This is the third round of winners in our 3v3 tournament. Phenom trying to find an opening. Yo, that long hair, son.
It's just the plan with the Nicali is just so easy to figure out. I mean, the options are very few, so you can really streamline your play style.
Exactly. Completely agree with you. It's just like you're just beating him over the head with offense. Ooh, he was looking for another Sonic Boom there, trying to get through there with the Disc Guidance.
A lot of jumping in on Chris G, and we're not seeing too many anti-airs.
So what he's essentially doing is looking for Chris G to stand so he can't eat a flash kick. Now, there's a lot of folks that subscribe to the mentality that Street Fighter V can reward off. Here's a I'll explain after this combo is not trivial. It rewards jumping in the sense that you might get anti-aired once, twice, but if you jump in enough times and get the one big hit, especially when you've got meter, you're going to exact so much damage that it was worth your while to get anti-aired by a couple of normals, especially for people who anti-air normal with jab or short. It's not in your best interest so much as it is you're making an educated guess and getting a high reward for a low risk. So Phenom,
Chris G putting in that work. Look at that, Phenom already lost more than half health. Ooh, definitely gonna get crush countered for missing that.
This is optimal damage here without using critical art. That should be over. Oh, it's not gonna matter though. He's gonna get another bread and butter combo off of it. Phenom, the beast, Nicali. Kyle is gonna be consoled by his many adoring fans in the tunnel. Phenom holding it down, taking out Chris G, and coming up next, we have got Ray Ray playing Chun-Li. Phenom looking to run it all the way back for his team.
Ray Ray serious. He takes Daigo out.
Yeah. You know, I was discussing that with
serious
Paul earlier.
Serious Chun playing.
Yep. Heavy offensive style. Great execution from Ray Ray. He is one of the foremost Marvel vs. Capcom 3 players in the world. You have to have execution to play that game. And he has brought that over to Street Fighter V. He is he's quickly moving up the ranks. As you had alluded to earlier, he defeated Daigo. When did he fight Daigo? Was it 2 months ago?
When it was for ECT?
Yes, East Coast Throwdown.
Mm-hmm. I have to make sure I said it correctly. Sometimes I say ETC, and I'm like, no, different game.
Shout outs to the man, the legend, that is L.I. Joe, doing great work for the East Coast of the United States.
All right, Chun Nicali. So it's still Team TPA versus Wong Nation.
Round one.
All right, so here we go. Nicali versus Chun. Chun-Li has got a lot of very long normals. She's going to need them to keep Nicali out. This is essentially like a two-pronged game, in which case, in where Chun-Li is going to have what I feel is a very decisive advantage in the early game until Nicali is able to get...
That was not safe.
I'm not too sure what Ray Ray was doing there.
Oh, yeah, see, you can't block too much. You're going to get thrown. Ooh, and again.
Go for
number
one.
Three. Oh, shimmied, and then gets in with the EX, bringing Ray Ray to stun. Jump in, big combo, big damage. Finish it with a grab.
That is all off of one mistake.
Throwing.
I don't know what that spinning bird kick was. It had to be an input error.
Execution error.
Which is so strange from Ray Ray, of all people.
He just said it. He's got such amazing execution.
I mean, like, I would much rather say that he tried to make a hard read and it didn't pan out. I would feel better about it. Ooh, goes in for the instant legs. I like that crouch jab.
That nice leg kick meeting him for the anti-air. Chun-Li, which tools doesn't she have? I always really fail to think, you know, she just has everything.
Yeah, she really does. Chun-Li is in a class to herself. She has every tool at her disposal. Very long normals, high V-trigger output damage, confirmable critical art up to just about any normal you can think of. She's got every tool. Multiple
too many. Too many tools. That's what I'm trying to get at.
Hey, why you gotta hate on my character, girl?
Here we go, right, into the critical art.
That is going to be heavy damage, especially because Chun-Li does have low health. She's a 950.
Ooh, he goes and with then the just over gets on top. We got Shine has to hold it down now for his team. Ray Ray goes out 0-2.
Ray Ray is not looking happy about that situation. Taking a seat.
We have Team Korea just looking at what is happening. What went down in that match.
And maybe scouting out an opponent.
Oh, never mind. Infill's napping. He's tired.
He's meditating. He's getting in his zone.
Well, it's always rough because the first day of the tournament, you know, everyone's jet lagged. They're just trying to get in, trying to do stuff.
He's got to stay awake as long as possible so you can get to bed afterwards. Unless you're degen.
And the pools are finally posted. So everyone go online, smash.gg. No, they're not on smash.gg. They are on the other site. You can find it from the Canada Cup Gaming website. It will link you from the main page to where you can check your pools.
All right, so coming up next, we have got Phenom looking to take it all back for Team TPA. Taking on Shine out of the Wong Nation. Does Shine have what it takes to take this down?
It's on floco.tv. That's where they are. Pardon me. You can find the Canada Cup Street Fighter 5 brackets on Floco. Floco.tv.
All right, posted. Here we go. Two games apiece.
Round one. Fight.
Shine, generally considered to be the foremost cut in. On the East Coast. Goes right in there. Gets in a nice bread and butter. Pushing Nikali immediately into the corner. I like the stagger on the low strong. Oh, but he overshot. He's placed himself into the corner now. Phenom is going to go right in there.
Yeah, you got to respect the stomp. Definitely was looking to go over the stomp and then got hit by it.
Yep.
Ooh, rush in.
Napping. He got caught napping there. Nervous guard for Phenom. Oh,
yeah, definitely got taken advantage of. Oh, very nice tech.
Great tech from Shine. Not in a bad spot. Ooh, he's looking to stagger him there. Oh, Phenom comes in with a command grab. This should be over. The first round's going to go to Phenom. Shine looks strong early on, but one V-trigger will do it. So
now
Shine.
We'll see. Can he hold the banana hat?
This is what it's all about, a win with the banana.
It's actually probably feathers. Yeah, it is.
It's a headdress, yeah.
I just have icing problem.
I want it to be a banana now, though. Like, yeah. There is a banana hat, though, in another stage.
Yeah, there is. Yeah. I'm confusing, though.
Oh, the crowd is getting hyped for this. They want Shine to take this down. Phenom trying to find his way out of the corner. Shine establishing himself.
Lead.
He's holding down that half of the stage right now. Ooh, he was looking for a safe jump setup, but he's a little late.
Karin has just such a great B-reversal. I really like it.
Yeah. Great character. Okay, so we've activated. Now this is where, the real mind game begins. Get a lot of damage output. We're going to chuck him into the corner. Oh, we got Clip trying to jump out. Wow, nice V-skill. Here we go. Big opportunity for Shine. Going to activate the V-trigger.
Going with the in and out, in and out.
Now you have to be very careful when you backdash out of those Rekkas. You're actually susceptible to being critical on reversal. Nothing you can do in that spot. Held in the block stun by the stomp.
Got caught up.
And gets chipped to death. The rare circumstance where chip actually occurs to kill in this game. Phenom showing everybody why he is one of the top Nikali players in the world.